Turning, I see Irma standing there watching us. She's dressed in black, in a cotton top, skirt and tights, with her name printed on a small badge on her chest. She opens her mouth as if to speak, but Gestur forestalls her.
That would be great, he says.
Good, Edda nods. I'll have your cases taken up to your rooms. As if by arrangement, two men emerge from a door behind the reception desk. One takes our luggage, the other is carrying a tray with four glasses. Iced tea, Edda says, made from wild thyme, flavoured with blueberry syrup. The ingredients are locally sourced, like almost all the refreshments we serve here. Please help yourselves. Oh, thanks, I say, taking a glass. The tea is delicious. Sweet, fresh, with a perfect balance between the blueberry and thyme. Even Ari and Leah drink it down and return empty glasses to the reception desk. As Irma introduces herself, I notice how nervous she seems, as if she's about to burst into giggles any minute or doesn't know where to look. Why don't we begin with the restaurant? She says, then pauses. Or, no, maybe the bar.
Whatever you think,
Gestur says, smiling. He's noticed too, I think. I should be used to people recognizing us, but I'm not. I've never got over that feeling of discomfort when someone stares at us too long or shows signs of being tongue-tied. Fortunately, few people betray themselves, but I know that most recognize us, or me at least. It's me they know, not Gestur. My face appears in the advertisements, and when there's news about us in the media, my name always comes before Gestur's, if he gets a mention at all. After all, he's not actually employed by my company. He only helps out when necessary.